Hello everyone, this is Dr. Ashish Vanmai and welcome to the video lecture on how to solve the problems of morphological image processing. This is video 3 in this series, and in this video we will see the problems of boundary detection. So let's look at the question. The question is, give the formulation of boundary extraction and perform it for the image shown below. Choose appropriate structuring element and show the results for all intermediate stages. And they have given an image over here, and they have said that the white blocks are 1 and the gray blocks are 0. For the convenience, let's write this image in terms of 1s and 0s. So all the blocks which are white will be represented by 1, and the corresponding gray blocks will be represented by 0. The boundary of an object in an image A is given as beta A, and its value is A minus A erode B. That means first we will erode the original image with the structuring element B, and whatever result, we will subtract that result from the original image, and that will give us the boundary. And the structuring element that is commonly used for boundary extraction is a 3+3 structuring element with all white or all values 1. So here you can see the structuring element, and the center of the structuring element will be the second row, second column. So the step 1 will be to erode the A with structuring element B. So you will be following the same step as we have seen in the video 1 and video 2. So we will take the image A and we will first pad it with zeros. Now here the structuring element B is of size 3+3, and there is one row above below the center and one column on left and right of the center of structuring element. Hence we will pad one row above and below A and one column on left and right of A with the zero value. To erode A with B, now we will see whether A totally contains B or not. For that we will keep the center of B at various locations in A pad, and we will find the underneath sub image. We will ensure that the center of B is always inside A only, that means inside the blue boundary over here. And if we have all ones in the sub image, then we will say that the B is totally contained and the corresponding output will be 1, otherwise the output will be 0. So we can see the corresponding result of the erosion in the third figure over here. The second step is to extract the boundary. For that, we are going to subtract the result of erosion from the original image A. So in this case, we can see the original image A in the first figure. The result of erosion is shown in the second figure. And when we subtract this result of erosion from the original image, the corresponding will be the extracted boundary, which is shown in the third figure over here. So whatever is this result is shown in the image form over here. So whatever ones we are shown with the white blocks, and whatever the zeros are shown with the gray blocks over here. And you can see that this process has actually extracted the boundary of the object in original image A. Hence we can see that the process of boundary extraction is very simple. It is just a simple operation of erosion and then a subtraction operation. Let's move to the next question. The question is, find the border of image F given below using two different structuring elements A and B respectively. And they have given the image F over here and two different structuring elements. So let's find the boundary of image F using the structuring element A. So in this case, we'll call that boundary as beta 1 F, and it will be given as F minus F erode A, where A is the structuring element given, which has the center element 1 and four neighbors also are 1. The diagonal neighbors of this center are 0. So again it will be a two-step process. First we will erode F with A, and then whatever the result we have, we will subtract it from F. So here to erode F by A, we will first pad A with zeros. So it is again a 3x3 structuring element with the center at the second row, second column. Hence we will pad one row and one column on either side of F with zeros. After padding zeros, we check whether F totally contains A or not. So for that, we will keep the center of A at different locations of F pad. Again, over here, we will ensure that the center lies inside the original image F only, that means inside the blue boundary. And we will check the underneath sub-image. Here, the structuring element has a center value 1 and the 4 neighbors as 1. So in the sub-image, we also want that the center value should be 1 and the 4 neighbors should be 1. If that happens, then we will say that the structuring element is totally contained and hence the output will be 1. Otherwise, the output will be 0. So correspondingly, you can see the result of the erosion, which is shown in the third figure over here. As a quick guess, if you look at the structuring element, it has center 1 and 4 neighbors as 1. Hence, when you perform the operation of erosion, it is going to shrink the image from left side, right side, from top as well as from bottom by 1 pixel. However, it will not shrink it diagonally. So, just remember that. In the second step, we are going to perform the boundary extraction by performing the subtraction operation. We will subtract the result of erosion, that is F erode A, from F. So both the images are shown over here, and the corresponding result of subtraction is shown in the next slide. So here you can see the result of the subtraction, which is nothing but the boundary of image F using the structuring element A. Now let's perform the boundary detection of F using the structuring element B. Again, we are going to follow the same steps as we have done in the earlier part. Only thing is the structuring element will be different. So it will be again the same formulation. So we represent the boundary due to structuring element B as B2F, and it will be F minus F erode B, where B is a structuring element which is a 3x3 with all elements as 1. Step 1 will be to erode F by B. So we will pad F first by one row and one column on either side with zeros, since B is again 3x3 over here. And then we will check whether F totally contains B or not. Now in this case, B has all 1s in the 3x3 structure. So whenever we extract the sub-image, we also want that sub-image also should have all 1s. Then only we will see that the B is totally contained and the corresponding output will be 1. Otherwise, the output will be 0. So you can see the corresponding result of erosion in third image. To extract the boundary, again we will subtract the result of erosion from F. So for simplicity, both the original image F and the result after erosion by B is shown over here. And this is the result of a boundary extraction. So here we are comparing the boundaries extracted by structuring element A and structuring element B. So first figure is the boundary extracted by structuring element A, and the second figure is the boundary extracted by structuring element B. And we have shown the boundaries with the blue color over here. To understand how these boundaries actually differ, so let's connect these entries with a red line. So when you connect them, you can see the boundary path because of structuring element A as well as structuring element B. Now if you observe carefully, then you will observe that when you extract the boundary using structuring element A, it allows you to take a diagonal path, whereas the structuring element B doesn't allow you to take a diagonal path. You will always find that the edges extracted, so the boundary extracted by B, will always take a path which is by four neighbors. So this brings us to the end of this video lecture. So I hope you have understood the process of boundary extraction, which is very simple. If you have any doubts, then of course you can write back to me at my email ID ivpashish@gmail.com. Thank you.